Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all my students and my viewers. Today is Tuesday and we are coming after a long time again. I made a video not last Saturday, a week before that, and today I am making another video. And there are so many good news, but among them, the major one is that our syllabus is reduced. Now, many will say why this is a good news, and many will question, and many will say that this is a exploitation of our education system. Many will raise questions that why they are reducing the syllabus. But as students and also as a teacher, I understand that in the times that we are living in, it's not easy to just complete everything which was there in our syllabus. So the reduced syllabus is released by the Jack Board. So I will be uploading a video today around, I guess, 6 o'clock or 7 o'clock. I will be uploading a video where I will be discussing about the reduced syllabus, and just share it as much as you can. I cannot give the link here in the description box, but because it will be uploaded at 7 o'clock in the channel Unconventional Learning. So let us continue with our chapter, Going Places. This chapter is not cut off from the syllabus, so we are having this chapter. However, there are two chapters which I've already done that is cut off from our syllabus. That will be discussed in the video which we'll be releasing soon, today itself. So let us see, turn to page number 81, and I discussed about how Geoff, the brother of Sophie, had a poster in his room which was of Danny Casey. So in a way we got a glimpse that he himself was a fan, had admired the footballer Danny Casey, and that's why he was ready to believe whatever Sophie was telling him, ki hum mile the Danny Casey se aur aisa hua waisa hua. Now Geoff somewhere also doubts her, and he says, tum aisa kyun soch rahi ho, Danny Casey ke paas bahut sari girls hai, why will he come to you? Sophie says, no, I know he doesn't have girls and all that. Sophie is in her own world, as I have discussed, and that's why she's not ready to accept ki Danny Casey kisi aur se hi baat kar sakta hai. She is only believing what she wants to believe. Now see that line, I've also marked it here. It was nothing like that, Geoff. It was me who spoke first. When I saw who it was, I said, excuse me, but aren't you Danny Casey? And he looked sort of surprised, and he looked and he said, yes, that's right. And I knew it must be him because he had the accent, you know, like when they interviewed him on television. So realize, when what we all do, we look at the celebrities on television itself. None of us, or very few, have met them in real life, but almost all of us have only seen them in television. Now we know, whenever we hear an actor's voice, we recognize, acha ye ye actor hai, ye ye actress hai. How do we recognize? Because we have seen a lot of times, we have seen their interviews, we have seen them acting in a movie, so we know how they talk, what is their accent. Similarly, here Sophie is saying कि हम समझ गए थे वो डैनी कैसी है क्योंकि उसका एक्सेंट है, यू नो ना कैसा एक्सेंट है जैसा टेलीविजन में दिखाया जाता है. सो शी सीज ऑल दोज थिंग्स एंड देन शी इज ट्राइंग टू इमेजिन एंड फैंटेसाइज अबाउट इट, एंड देन उसको ही रियलिटी मान चुकी है. सो आई आस्क्ड हिम फॉर एन ऑटोग्राफ फॉर लिटिल डेरेक, बट नीदर ऑफ अस हैड अ पेपर और पेन. सो ऑब्वियसली अगर ये सच होता तो वो ऑटोग्राफ उसके पास होता, पर यहां पर इसको कहानी बनाना है. The point is, Sophie is not lying here. Sophie is not lying because usko aisa lag raha hai, whatever she is imagining or whatever she is has fantasized, that is the reality. Usko ye pata hi nahi hai ki uska fantasy jo fantasy hai, usko lagta hai ki uska reality hai wo. She is not even thinking ki wo fantasize kar rahi hai, usko lag raha hai wo real mein uske sath ho raha hai, jabki wo kya kar rahi hai, she is only imagining it. She is saying, na pen tha na paper tha, so we couldn't have an autograph. Now, so then we just talked a bit about the clothes in Royce's window. He seemed lonely. After all, it's a long way from west of Ireland. And then just as he was going, he said he if I would care to meet him next week, he would give me an autograph then. Of course, I said I would. So because इसको फिर से fantasy में involve होना है, फिर से imagine करना है, तो यहाँ पर ये एक story इसका ये फॉलो होता है कि क्योंकि हम लोग को इस बार ऑटोग्राफ नहीं मिलता है, शी इज सेइंग दैट शी इज टेलिंग हर ब्रदर जी ऑफ दैट डैनी केसी हमसे पूछता है कि हम दोबारा उससे मिलना चाहेंगे, एंड आई सेड यस ऑब्वियसली. ओके, सो यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड वेयर शी इज गोइंग. As if he never show up. So Geoff is saying, as if वो कभी आएगा तुमसे मिलने. You do believe me now, don't you? So Sophie is continuously focusing on this thing and she's asking her brother, अब तुम मेरे पे यकीन करते हो ना? And she's trying to validate her fantasy by her brother's approval. मतलब वो अपने जो भी fantasy है उसको वो एक ठोस सच के तौर पे शी इज ट्राइंग टू प्रूव इट ओनली व्हेन हर ब्रदर विल एक्सेप्ट इट दैट शी इज नॉट लाइंग एंड शी इज टेलिंग द ट्रूथ. ही ड्रैग्ड हिज जैकेट व्हिच वाज शाइनी एंड शेपलेस. हु इज ही हियर? जियोफ. ही ड्रैग्ड हिज जैकेट व्हिच वाज शाइनी एंड शेपलेस फ्रॉम द बैक ऑफ द चेयर, पुश्ड हिज आर्म इनटू इट. शी विश्ड ही पेड मोर अटेंशन टू हिज अपीयरेंस, विश्ड ही केयर मोर अबाउट क्लोथ्स. ही वाज टॉल विद अ स्ट्रॉन्ग डार्क फेस, हैंडसम, शी थॉट. इट्स द अनलाइकलीएस्ट थिंग आई हैव एवर हर्ड, ही सेड. So here we see a sister who is focusing on her brother's attire means dress. Dekh rahi hai mera bhai kaisa dikh raha hai, shakal kaisa hai and all that. Doesn't mean that she's liking her brother in a negative sense. She is possessive of her brother, which means wo apne bhai ko leke bahut zyada over possessive hai. She wants her brother only to be hers. Sirf mera bhai hai, mere pe dhyan dega. That is the kind of mentality she's having. एंड जियोफ बदले में क्या जवाब देता है जब सोफी उससे पूछती है तुम अब बिलीव करते हो ना? जियोफ सेड इट्स द अनलाइकलीएस्ट थिंग आई हैव एवर हर्ड. अनलाइकली जो कि कभी किसी से मिलता जुलता नहीं हो, कभी ऐसा सुना नहीं गया हो, दैट इज अनलाइकली. सो ये सबसे अनलाइकली चीज है जो हम आज तक सुने जियोफ इज सेइंग. नाउ अगेन देयर आर एस्ट्रिक साइंस हियर व्हिच मीन अब सीन फिर से चेंज हो गया. ओके, on Saturday they made their weekly pilgrimage to Wash United. Sophie and her father and little Derek went down near the goal. Geoff, as always, went with his mates higher up. United won 2-0 and Casey drove in the second goal. A blend of innocence and Irish genius going around the two big defenders on the edge of the penalty area. Father screaming. So here a small description is giving. Jahan unka pura family, they have gone to a weekly pilgrimage. Weekly pilgrimage matlab har Saturday they might be going to a stadium or anywhere, and they were watching the match, okay, live, and that's why they are discussing about it. The description is there how Danny Casey was playing, the Irish genius Danny Casey, he's playing and all those things. Afterwards Geoff, Sophie, see the last line of that paragraph, Sophie glowed with pride. Afterwards, Geoff was ecstatic. Sophie glowed with pride. क्योंकि सोफी को लगा था जो इंसान वहां ग्राउंड पे खेल रहा है वो हम उससे मिले हैं, वो हमको जानता है. And that's why वो अपने ही दुनिया में जो ख्याली पुलाव, the term is used, she is cooking that and she's enjoying and she's in her own world. Geoff was ecstatic. Ecstatic again, extremely happy. He was very happy that the footballer whom he admired so much is playing so well and all those things. I wish he was an Englishman, someone said on the bus. Ireland will win the World Cup, little Derek told his mother when Sophie brought him home. Her father was gone to the had gone to the pub to celebrate. So here, simple description, nothing serious. What is this that you have been telling? Jansi said next week. So दूसरे हफ्ते में Jansi ऐसे ही किसको बोलती है? Obviously Sophie को. कि ये क्या है जो तुम बार बार बोले जा रही हो, सबको बोले जा रही हो? अबाउट वॉट? सोफी सेज योर जियोफ टोल्ड आर फ्रैंक यू मेट डैनी केसी. सो ही सेइंग तुम्हारा जो जियोफ भाई है, वो मेरा भाई फ्रैंक को या कोई भी होगा, उसको ये बताया है कि तुम डैनी केसी से मिली हो. नाउ लुक एट सोफीज रिएक्शन. सोफी वॉज दैट काइंड ऑफ अ सिस्टर हु ऑलवेज वॉन्टेड हिज ब्रदर टू बी ओनली हर्स. वो पोजेसिव थी, एंड यहां पर उसका इतना बड़ा सीक्रेट जियोफ किसी को बता चुका है. What will be her reaction? How will she behave? Let us see as the story proceeds. This wasn't an inquisition, just Jansi being nosy, but Sophie was startled. So यहाँ पर लिखा हुआ है कि ये कोई question नहीं था. Sophie Jansi nosy बन रही थी. Nosy as in अपना नाक हर जगह घुसाना, trying to come in between any argument or any discussion और सुनना क्या बात हो रहा है. So Jansi was doing that. Sophie was startled, लिखा है. Startled, shocked, surprised. She was very surprised because obviously she wanted her brother only to know the she wanted her brother to be the only person to know her secret and not anybody else. Oh, that, she says. Jhansi frowned, sensing she was covering. So Jhansi ko samajh mein aa gaya ki acha tum chupa rahi ho kuch. Yes, that. Well, yes, I did. So Sophie saying, haan, bole the. You never did. As in, hum mile the Danny Casey se. You never did, Jhansi exclaimed. So Jhansi saying, chhoot mat bolo, tum kabhi nahi mili ho. Sophie glared at the ground. So she glared, she was staring at the ground. Because obviously she was shocked that uska bhai itna bada secret kisi aur ko bata diya hai. Damn that Geoff. Now look, this was a Geoff thing, not a Jhansi thing. So a typical teenage behavior where a teenage says, ye sirf aapko pata hona chahiye, ye sirf tumko pata hona chahiye, tum us friend ko kyun batai, ye sirf tumhare janne ke liye tha. So similar kind of thing is going on. It was meant to be something special between them. So, यहाँ author जो है हम लोग को बता रहे हैं कि Sophie इतना ज़्यादा Geoff को लेके concern थी कि वो सिर्फ जो Sophie and Geoff के बीच का बात होना चाहिए था. Something secret. It wasn't a Jhansi kind of thing at all. Tell Gawky Jhansi something like that and the whole neighborhood would get to know it. Damn that Geoff. Was nothing sacred? So author is telling us, he's saying that A.R. Barton, who is the author, is telling us that Sophie became very angry and she was very shocked because this, whatever she told Geoff about Danny Casey, it was only supposed to be kept within Geoff itself because yahan pe kya likha, it was a Geoff thing, not a Jhansi thing. Kyunki ye hum log ko bata raha hai how much Sophie was possessive about her brother. And that's why she's saying ki agar ek baar Jhansi ko pata chal gaya, matlab sab ko pata chal jayega. And then she says, it's a secret meant to be. I'll keep a secret, Soph. You know that. So Jhansi is saying, hum secret rakh lenge, don't worry. I was going to tell anyone. I wasn't going to tell anyone. There'll be a right old row if my dad gets to hear about it. So Sophie is saying, hum kisi ko waise bhi batane nahi wale the. Mere ghar ke bahar bhid lag jayega. Mere papa ko pata chal jayega. Please don't tell all those things, these things to anybody. Jhansi blinked a row. I thought he'd be shocked as anything. So Jhansi is just questioning her. She realized that Jhansi didn't know about the dead bit. Okay. So jaise Jhansi behave karti ki tumhare ghar ke samne bheed kyun lagega? Then Sophie realizes, acha, Geoff se itna bataya hai ki Danny Casey se meri behan ek baar mili hai. Ye nahi bataya hai ki dobara milne wali hai. So Sophie becomes happy. अच्छा चलो, एक तो मेरा भाई सीक्रेट रखा, मतलब हमको वो रिस्पेक्ट किया है मेरा ये सीक्रेट का, सेक्रेट है उसके लिए. एंड शी गोज इन हर ओन वर्ल्ड. सी व्हाट शी सेइंग, शी रियलाइज्ड देन दैट Jhansi डिडंट नो अबाउट द डेड बिट. Geoff हैडंट टोल्ड अबाउट दैट. शी ब्रीथ्ड मोर इजिली. सो Geoff हैडंट लेट हर डाउन आफ्टर ऑल. ही बिलीव्ड इन हर आफ्टर ऑल सम थिंग्स माइट बी सेक्रेट. So again, she's saying the same thing that yes, मेरे भाई बहन के बीच वो प्योरिटी है, वो सीक्रेट भी रखा है मेरा भाई और नहीं बताया है. Jesus, I wish I had been there. Sorry, just let me go before that. It was just a little thing really. I asked him for an autograph, but we didn't have any pen or paper, so it was no good. How much had Geoff said? She's saying, अरे ऐसा कुछ बहुत बड़ी बात नहीं थी और वैसे भी मेरा भाई Geoff कितना बताया. Jesus, I wish I would have been there. So Jhansi saying, काश हम वहां रहते. And she exclaims, she takes the name of God and she's saying, काश हम वहां रहते. Of course my dad didn't want to believe it. You know what a misery he is, but the last thing I need is cues. So again, line, cue means line of people around our house asking him, what's all this about Danny Casey? Murder me, you know how my mom gets. Okay, so she's again behaving like a typical teenager. Tum janti ho meri mom kaisa behave karegi, sab kaisa ho jayega agar pata chal jayega, and all those things. Jhansi said, hushed, you can trust me, Soph, you know that. So she is making her believe, tum humko mere pe bharosa kar sakti ho, Soph. She's telling her friend. And then Sophie obviously becomes silent. Now after this, what happens? I will finish the chapter in the next class where again we have already got a notice ki Sophie fir se imagine karne wali hai, fantasize karne wali hai, kyunki wo dobara milne wali hai Danny Casey se. So obviously wo second time wala cheez yahan par hoga and it's a bit tricky. So do not miss the lecture, the last part of this chapter. I will finish the chapter in the next class hopefully, and then we will revise because we will be completing our syllabus. So stay tuned for the next lecture, and also keep waiting for the video which will talk about the reduced syllabus of JACBOARD class 12. Okay, so thank you so much, and stay safe, keep studying, and all the best for your boards. Thank you.